Primary biliary cholangitis is a chronic autoimmune disease affecting the liver. This gradual damage begins with the destruction of bile ducts within the liver. Bile, produced by the liver, travels through these ducts to the small intestine where it helps digest fat, absorb fat-soluble vitamins, and remove waste. When the bile ducts are damaged, bile builds up in the liver, causing inflammation and scarring. Over time, this scarring can progress to cirrhosis, a condition where healthy liver tissue is replaced by scar tissue, impairing liver function and causing serious complications. There are medications available to slow down liver damage caused by primary biliary cholangitis. The first-line treatment is ursodeoxycholic acid. However, up to 40% of patients with biliary cholangitis may not respond fully to this medication. Obeticholic acid could be added if there is an inadequate response, but it is not suitable for patients with advanced cirrhosis. This underscores the need for additional treatment options. In August 2024, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration approved Seladelpar, under the brand name Livdelzi, for treating primary biliary cholangitis. Adults who don't respond well to ursodeoxycholic acid alone can add Seladelpar to their treatment regimen. For those who can't tolerate ursodeoxycholic acid, Seladelpar can be used as a single treatment. Seladelpar is a selective agonist for the peroxisome proliferator-activated receptor delta, or PPARδ in short, which plays a crucial role in regulating various metabolic and inflammatory pathways in the liver. Activation of PPARδ triggers hepatocytes to release fibroblast growth factor, or FGF21. This peptide hormone, in turn, activates the c-Jun N-terminal kinase signaling pathway. This chain of events culminates in the downregulation of CYP7A1, an enzyme essential for converting cholesterol into bile acids. Consequently, the overall production of bile acids is decreased. Additionally, Seladelpar reduces the number of pro-inflammatory macrophages. The RESPONSE trial was a phase 3 study that evaluated the effectiveness and safety of Seladelpar in patients with primary biliary cholangitis. 193 patients, who had not responded well to ursodeoxycholic acid or experienced intolerable side effects from it, were randomly assigned 2-to-1 to receive either Seladelpar, 10 mg daily, or a placebo. The main goal was to see if Seladelpar could improve liver function, as measured by a decrease in alkaline phosphatase levels and a return to normal bilirubin levels after 12 months. Seladelpar showed promising results in the trial. About 62% of patients who took Seladelpar achieved significant improvement in their liver function, as measured by a decrease in alkaline phosphatase levels. This was much higher than the 20% of patients who received placebo. Of note, treatment with Seladelpar led to the normalization of alkaline phosphatase values, a positive sign of liver health, in 25% of patients at month 12. This change was not seen in any patients receiving placebo. Seladelpar also helped reduce itching, a bothersome symptom for many people with biliary cholangitis. Among patients with moderate to severe pruritus at baseline, Seladelpar recipients had a greater reduction in the pruritus numerical rating scale score at month 6. This effect lasted throughout the treatment period. The most common adverse events reported among patients taking Seladelpar were headache, abdominal pain, abdominal distension, and nausea. Seladelpar represents a promising new therapeutic option for patients with primary biliary cholangitis, particularly those who are intolerant to or do not respond adequately to existing treatments. Its ability to improve liver function markers and alleviate symptoms like itching suggests it could significantly enhance the quality of life for individuals suffering from this condition. Ongoing studies and regulatory reviews are expected to further clarify its role in managing primary biliary cholangitis. And that's it for today's pharmacology video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more pharmacology content.